presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, interface changes to ProPresenter 7.9. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you have been noticing that ProPresenter looks a little different and wondering what those differences are, go ahead and click the thumbs up, like, subscribe, click the little bell icon, you know, all the stuff that the YouTubers tell you to do. So, this is something that may be immediately obvious to you, but I thought that we'd head over to my computer and I'd show you some of the obvious and less obvious things in ProPresenter 7.9. So, obviously, right up here, these look different. They're actually up here instead of down here. And the first thing you'll probably notice is the red circle. It used to be that they were like that, green or red. But, and I don't have any official word, I think that the reason that they've changed this is because if you're colorblind, it's really obvious, because this isn't filled in, that this is, in fact, a non-filled-in circle. And if it's on, it's a filled-in circle. So you don't even have to be able to see red and green or distinguish between red and green in order for that to work. So that's the first thing. Second thing, this icon right here. It says worship right now, but it is a look. Shows you the different looks. So instead of just knowing kind of inductively based on what is said elsewhere, you could look and say, oh, turns out that I'm on worship, but I should be on the message. And you can change that from here. So you can change that and you can go back. So nice and easy to be able to switch between those, and at a glance, because they're labeled, as long as you've changed the names of each, you can know which one that you're in. Another thing is the live up here used to be down here in this area. Kind of, they scooted everything down and had a couple of extra places there, but instead now it's up here with all these icons. So that's a nice little change as well. Something else that you may not, it's not obvious immediately, but the first time that you right-click on a piece of media, you'll notice that we've got a much longer list of things. I'm told that this is more similar to the way that it is in Pro Video Player. So that's helpful, and it's also helpful because, you know, with a single click you can change to the foreground behavior instead of background, change the scaling, change how it loops or doesn't loop, stuff like that. So that's pretty cool as well. So that's something else. Something that you may not know, because maybe you don't use this feature, maybe your eyes are younger than mine, but I call this old people mode. Now, I'm 48, I'm not, you know, older than that, but in your 40s, typically people's eyes become less good, not as capable of focusing on smaller things. So by clicking this, notice how big these words are. That's great. But there's a problem there. What if there was a piece of media in here that I wanted to see? In fact, I know that there's a piece of media here because it's the background to this. So what if I wanted to see where the media was and where it wasn't? Well, no problem. I can click on this little ellipsis in the circle here, and there's a checkbox here, show media action. So when I do that, then that shows up. Now it's the case that it's not exactly the way that it is when it's showing up. You know, it's not like the other view, which is right here. So can see the difference when I toggle between them, but it at least enables me to read things more easily. Although I will admit that here without a drop shadow or an outline or something, it's a little more difficult. But it does enable me to read these slides more easily and see where media is. So this might be really helpful if your pastor still is back in the 90s using PowerPoint and insists on bringing PowerPoint into ProPresenter instead of doing it the modern way and making slides within ProPresenter itself. Then you could have this up for all the other items. You know, notice that I'm on a song here and I can see where I have background changes and everything. But then if I went to a PowerPoint presentation, then if they were still images that were just brought into ProPresenter, then I could still see them right there without switching back over to the slides view. So that's another little difference in the UI in ProPresenter 7.9. Finally, one thing. We have these clear groups that were added in the last couple of versions. There's so many, I'm starting to forget which one had which addition. But now I can right-click, configure clear groups, and I have the ability to, under the presentation layer, select clear next. Why would I want to do this? Well, let's say that I don't know what the arrangement is going to be. So I haven't had a chance to change it. I haven't had a chance to tweak it. I know when the song is going to end, but that's basically all I know, right? So this happened a couple of weeks ago at my own church where the worship leader didn't get us the final arrangement until right before the ending song was about to start. So, as a result, when you cleared the lyrics, the next slide's lyrics might still be up in the stage screen. So, when you change this to clear next, when you use this not announcement, which is one that I made here, because it clears everything but the announcements layer, then not only does it clear the current slide, but on the stage screen, it clears the next slide as well. So any singers that are singing along and have lost track of where they are, they can absolutely know, oh, wait, there's no next thing up here, we're done singing. So a helpful little thing right there as well. So that is all the interface changes in ProPresenter 7.9. If you like this content, you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and I will absolutely make a login and password for you so you can take that class whenever you want. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.